Hey y'all, hey, Amanda here, and today we're doing November empties. And per usual, they are just thrown into my little green bucket in kind of a clusterfuck fashion. So, there's gonna be no rhyme or reason to this. And there usually isn't anyway, so I don't know why I'm explaining it. Let's just get straight into it. First thing is the Orange Sapphire Shower Gel from the Signature Collection at Bath & Body Works. This is the full-sized one. I really like this, and so does Austin. We usually just share the same body wash because it's easier. He doesn't really care what it smells like, but this one actually was a great unisex scent. I will definitely repurchase this in the future if it's still around, because it smells amazing, and we both really liked it. Next thing is the Bedhead TG Ego Boost Split End Mender Leave-In Conditioner. Nothing is going to mend your split ends, so that's false. Cross that out. As a leave-in conditioner, it was didn't do a ton. I preferred to use this for styling purposes, because usually when I get out the shower, if I'm not feeling lazy, I will, you know, help my curls along, help them curl so they don't turn into frizz, and I used that for that. But I wouldn't repurchase it. Although the package is really cute, right? Yeah. Next we have the Giovanni Eco Chic Body Care Hot Chocolate Sugar Scrub. Oh my god, this smells so good. It smells just like hot chocolate. It's an amazing scrub. You just feel silky smooth after you use it. I would definitely purchase this again, and I highly recommend it. I used, let's see, I wrote the name, the Sparkly Pumpkin, I guess, Bubble Bar or Bath Bomb. I don't know the difference, really. But I used that up, and I really liked it, and I would purchase it again next year. It made the water really silky and lovely. I used the Fresh Black Tea Aged Clay Cream. This was a sample size. I think this came from Nordstrom. I'm not entirely sure. It smells like peeled potatoes. Yep, that's exactly how it smells like. It smells like when you're peeling potatoes, and that is rather off-putting. And I don't think it did a ton for me, so I wouldn't recommend it or repurchase it. Not that I purchased it to begin with, because it was a sample. Next, we have the Clean and Clear Dual Action Moisturizer with Salicylic Acid Acne Medication, oil-free, moisturizes dry skin, blah, 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 blah. I don't think this was moisturizing enough for me. I finished it up, but I don't think I would repurchase this. It wasn't enough for me, but I don't think it's necessarily bad. This is not finished, but I'm just tossing it because I'm sick of seeing it. It's the Naturally Fresh Deodorant Crystal Roll-On Deodorant. It's just like a liquid, and then there's a little roller ball on top. This does nothing. It's like basically water. There's no point in this. Don't get it. I finished the First Aid Beauty Skin Rescue Deep Cleanser with Red Clay. And this was nice. I don't think I would repurchase it. I'd like to move my skincare a different direction. I think I'm gonna start using mostly only Paula Choice once I finish up what I have. But it was nice to try. I think it cleaned fairly well. But I don't think it did anything to help with any of my facial issues. I finished up the Lush Mint Julep Lip Scrub, and while this is a nice lip scrub, it just doesn't do enough for me. I need like really rough abrasion, and the sugar scrubs just aren't enough for me. I'm thinking of keeping the little glass container though and doing something with it. I'm not sure what though. If your lips are not, you know, ironclad like mine and don't need to be beat to death in order to be exfoliated, I think it's a good product. But it is something you can make yourself. But if you don't want to, then buy it. I have the Up and Up brand cotton rounds that I finished a pack of, and I like them. They're pretty good. I'm definitely going to repurchase once I need to, but I have like a million packs of them, so I like this one. I did this morning. It's the Dr. Jart Pore Minimalist Black Charcoal Sheet Mask. It says it's good for pimples, large pores, and excess sebum. Well, it did not magically make my pimples, like, disappear, so I don't know how it's good for pimples. Maybe it treats them. It did nothing for my pores. They are still just as large as I left them beforehand. And as for excess sebum, I don't know what that means. Like, is it supposed to extract it? Like, what does that even mean? Because my blackheads are still exactly where they were beforehand. So, it was a fun mask to do, and it felt really nice, but I don't know if it really did anything significant beyond adding moisture to my skin. Ooh, another Lush item. Let's see, what was this? Pink bath bomb. I like this. It smelled good. I would buy it again. The next thing is the Caudalie Paris hands and nail cream. I really, really liked this. Of the little set that I got from Birchbox, I think. Yeah, I used my Birchbox points for it. This is probably my favorite thing. This and the little lip balm chapstick thing. I really like this. I would definitely repurchase it. And I think Sephora has like a hand cream set right now for the holiday season. So it has like 3 different scents. If you're interested, I would definitely pick that up. I have a few other hand creams to get through, but I really, really like this one. This was a lip mask. I've talked about these before. They're not great. They slide all over the place, but I'm trying to finish them. So I did one of those. This is the Glam Naturals, or Glam Natural Black Mascara. This shit sucks. I have a review of it. I'll put the link down below. It just does nothing. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. This is the Dr. Brandt Pores No More Vacuum Cleaner Blackhead Extractor Mask, which does not extract blackheads. So it doesn't do what it said it's going to do, so it's pretty pointless. Oh, I used these e.l.f. Dramatic Lashes for Halloween. They are pretty fake looking, but for my costume, they are perfect. So, I can't recommend purchasing these if you're someone who wears lashes all the time. But if you're looking for something obviously fake, large, extravagant for a costume, these are great, and they're only like a dollar, I think. Next is the Tarina Tarantino Pearl Glow Primer. As you can see, there's still a ton left in there, and it won't come out. It just will not go through the pump and come out. Now, I'm not fighting it to get it out because this is a glass bottle, and I don't want to hurt myself. So, yeah, I didn't love it. It made me oily. It didn't prime very well, so not the greatest. This is the Caudalie Makeup Removing Cleansing Water. This burned the shit out of my eyes. I can't recommend it. Maybe if you only use it on your face, but if you're going to do that, just use a makeup removing wipe. It's so much easier. So I can't recommend that, unfortunately. This is the Julep Freedom Polymer Top Coat. This is shit. My nails chipped so bad every time I used this. I hate it. Do not buy it. It's awful. We have a couple perfume samples. Let's see. Prada Candy. It was nice, but there was some sort of... One of the like underlying notes in here was rubbing me the wrong way. I wasn't loving it. So I wouldn't purchase that. Dolce but Dolce Gabbana. I don't remember what this smelled like, so I guess it didn't leave a huge impact on me. Angel by Thierry Mugler. I had to actually stop using this. It just wasn't for me. It stunk. I couldn't even finish it. And then Tommy Girl by Tommy Hilfiger. This was nice. I enjoyed using it, but I don't enjoy it enough to purchase it. Let's see. Just a few things left. We have the Paula's Choice Hydrolite Complete System, step by step. So I finished this up with all the little samples that come in it. Oh gosh, they're falling everywhere. It comes broken down by day and night. And I really enjoyed this. I thought that the products were really great. I really loved the 1% BHA lotion because I definitely saw my face improve just over the weekend I used this. So I really like this. I'm interested in purchasing some of these products once I finish up some other skincare I have. Next, unfortunately I broke this, but I'm going to show it to you anyway, is the Pumpkin Caramel Latte candle. This one did not burn down as well as I hoped. You could just see if I move the sticker a little. There's still like, that's a pretty tall amount there. More than I usually have. It's usually a few centimeters or no, millimeters, shorter than that. But it smelled really good. I would say this smelled more like pancakes. It smelled more breakfasty than the other one I'm about to show you. Actually, let me just show you both. This is pumpkin pecan waffles. I think that whoever labeled these at Bath & Body Works got it backwards. This one smells more like, I don't know, more like pancake waffle kind of scent. This one smells more like, I don't know, coffee latte kind of scent. Yeah, they're totally backwards, but they were both really delicious and yummy, and I loved them both, so I enjoyed these, and I recommend them. That is everything that I used up this month. If you have any questions about the products, you can leave them down below, or if you have any comments you'd like to leave, by all means, leave that down below, too. Thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and I would love to know what you used up this month, so if you have a video, definitely let me know down below, and subscribe if you're interested in staying around for a while, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!